Kanak Bhaiya, two layers as we have seen. The first layer is tunica albuginea and the second layer is tunica vaginalis. In the tunica albuginea convolutes inwardly. It forms an inward folding and forming a septum. So this internal structure of the testis is divided into numerous compartments because of the inward folding of the tunica albuginea, that is the fibrous layer that surrounds the testis. It convolutes inwardly and forms septae and forms numerous compartments, and these compartments are called as lobules, and they form around maximum of 250 to 300 lobules, and each lobule consists of a coiled structure which becomes linear towards the end. This coiled structure is called as seminiferous tubules. Each lobule contains about three seminiferous tubules. So as a total, it constitutes about 900 seminiferous tubules. Already we have seen that there will be a maximum of 300 lobules present in the testis. So if we each lobule consists of three seminiferous tubules, obviously there will be 900 seminiferous tubules in the whole testis. So the seminiferous tubules is the site of production of sperm. The sperm is produced in the seminiferous tubule. It is a coiled structure, and it is linear towards the end, and it opens into a linear structure called retae testis. This retae testis is formed by the numerous seminiferous tubule which gets connected and forms a network. This network is called as retae testis, and this retae testis opens out in a small tubular structure called vas efferentia. This is the internal structure of the testis. Here the sperm is formed in the seminiferous tubule, and it is conducted by the retae testis, and this retae testis opens in vasa efferentia, and vasa efferentia transport the sperms to epididymis. Epididymis is present in the posterior side of the testis, and this epididymis carries the sperm into urinogenital tract outside the scrotal sac. It is taken to urinogenital tract after it is conducted by the epididymis. Coming to the section of testis, it is a cross section of testis. So obviously there will be seminiferous tubules. These large parts are called seminiferous tubule, and it is surrounded by interstitial spaces. In this interstitial spaces have blood capillaries and a mass of tissues, and this mass of tissues is called as interstitial tissue or Leydig cells. Because it is present in the interstitial space, it is called as interstitial cells. It is also called as Leydig cells. This Leydig cells secretes testosterone hormone, which is the male hormone. And this seminiferous tubule consists of two cells, the glandular cuboidal cells called germ cells, and a tall triangular cells called Sertoli cells. These germ cells are the mother cell for male gametes, and it undergoes mitotic division to form primary spermatogonia, and then it undergoes meiotic division to form the male gamete, that is spermatozoid, that is sperm. This Sertoli cells are also called as nurse cells, as they provide nourishment to the germ cells during the process of spermatogenesis. So this germ cells will be involved in the process of spermatogenesis, while Sertoli cells doesn't involve in the process of spermatogenesis. These are called as nurse cells because they provide the nourishment for the germ cells during spermatogenesis. So this is about the internal structure of testis and the section of testis. Now we will move on to the secondary sex organs. After the sperm is produced in the seminiferous tubules of the testis, it is passed through retae testis, and it is carried over by vasa efferentia, and it meets the epididymis. Here in the epididymis is a very coiled structure but I have drawn like this to show the various part of the epididymis, but it is a very coiled structure. The epididymis has a head, body and a tail part. The upper part is called the head, which is called as caput epididymis, and the body part is called as carpus epididymis, and the tail part is called as cauda epididymis, and the tail part extends into the duct. Here in the epididymis, the sperm is stored for 18 to 24 hours and it attains physiological maturity in the epididymis, that is capacitation. The sperm attains the capacitation in epididymis where it is physiologically matured. This is the whole structure of the male reproductive system. It is a scrotal sac and it is a testis. In the posterior end of the testis is the epididymis. The vasa afferentia in the testis open out in the epididymis, where the sperm reaches epididymis and get physiologically matured. And the epididymis opens into the another duct called vasa deferens, and this vasa deferensa opens into the urethra. Here it is a bladder. As we all know that in the male reproductive system, it is a urinogenital tract where the urine and the genetic material, that is the male gamete, are conducted by the same tract, and this urinogenital tract extends throughout and meet at the urinal duct, and it is called as urethra meatus. And this is the penis is the extra genital organ, and it is a copulatory organ, and it is swollen at the end. So it has a swollen tip and it is called as glans penis, and this glans penis has a loose foreskin, and it is called as prepuce. Here it has a loose foreskin and it is called as prepuce, and it is very sensitive. And coming to the accessory genital glands present, seminal vesicle is present here, which is coiled in nature and it is paired. It is actually one side of the scrotal sac. Another testis will be present here. The replica of these structures will be present here. And the seminal vesicle is the coiled structure. And prostate gland is the donut-shaped gland that is present at the the connection of the genital system to the urinary system. And Cowper's gland or bulbourethral gland is also a paired gland present below the prostate gland. And this Cowper's gland secretes proteins which act as the lubricant during copulation process. The seminal vesicle secretes protein, and prostate gland also secrete protein, which constitute the semen, which carries the sperm. Actually, from here, after the seminal vesicle, this duct is called as the ejaculatory duct, where the sperm is surrounded with semen. Semen is nothing but the protein which is secreted by the seminal vesicle and a prostate gland. The seminal vesicle also secrete fructose which is seen only in the semen. This fructose cannot be seen in any other part of the body, so it helps in the forensic judgment. If there is a sexual harassment and if fructose is seen at that place, then it is confirmed that it is a sexual harassment due to the presence of fructose, because that fructose is seen only in the seminal vesicle secretion and not in any other part of the human body. This seminal vesicle and prostate gland secretes protein which nourishes the sperm and also helps in the copulation process. This Cowper's gland or bulbourethral gland secretes protein which acts as the lubricant during the copulation process. And also this secretions consist of zinc. We don't know the actual effect of zinc on the sperm, but if there is if the amount of zinc present in the semen reduces, it leads to infertility. It affects the fertility of the sperm. So we don't know what is the actual function of the zinc, but if there is any reduction in the amount of zinc produced, that results in the effect that results affects the fertility of the sperm, that results in infertility. So this is all about the male reproductive system. We will move on to the female reproductive system now.